June 12, 2018, a historical day. Leaders from the United States and the Democratic People's Republic of Korea are finally meeting for the first time after the end of the Korean War in 1953. That message has been made from the US President Donald Trump and the top leader of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, Kim Jong Un, after the historic meeting in Singapore on Tuesday, June 12. Medias all around the world look at this photo and know the historical moment of the handshake between the two leaders. Negotiations were held in an atmosphere full of mutual good wish and readiness to solve the problems. President Donald Trump also promised to invite leader Kim Jong-un in the White House. US President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un promised to work on a nuclear-free Korean peninsula. Also, Washington has pledged to provide security guarantees to Pyongyang, said news agencies from all around the world. President Donald Trump also said that the denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula could begin very, very fast. US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo and North Korean representatives will hold further negotiations as soon as possible.
I feel really great. We're going to have a great discussion, and I think tremendous success. They'll be tremendously successful. And it's my honor, and we will have a terrific relationship, I have no doubt.
The joint statement signed by the two leaders has little detail on how and in what deadline the goals will be achieved, said Reuters. Experts recall that 10 years ago there were talks of denuclearization on the peninsula, but that goal was never fulfilled. Today they think that the process will last for at least a decade, it will be expensive and will require the signing of a non-assault contract between the two countries.
The fact that both of them got to know each other and perhaps trust each other is good for future negotiations.
A lot of residents from China, the United States and South Korea were optimistic about the development in the Korean Peninsula situation, hoping that the document the two leaders signed during their meeting in Singapore was a denuclearization agreement. A Chinese resident in Beijing said that if that's true, it's good news for the regional and global security. A US resident added that with the positive vibes coming out of the summit, it looks like a peace deal might be around the corner.
I hope things get better. We don't want to have nukes on our heads, so. But then it should be a deal, the same deal for everyone.
Trump called the just concluded one-on-one talks a tremendous success. And leader Kim Jong-un also spoke highly of the summit. A lot of South Koreans think about the summit as a victory.
정상회담도 긍정적이었으니까 북미회담도 좀 그 기대를 좀 해봅니다.
Here in Eastern Europe, during the whole day, Bulgarian televisions, radio stations and online medias followed the historical summit.
Историческа среща.
Тръмп срещна Ким.
За първи път действащ американски президент ще се срещне със севернокорейски лидер.
Every media who worked on the news presented it with a different, unique style. Some made live connections from the US with various international experts, others were working from their studios or newsrooms.
Европейският съюз обяви срещата в Сингапур като доказателство, че пътят към мира минава през дипломацията.
A lot of radio stations talk for hours about not only for the US Democratic People's Republic of Korea summit, but also for the Inter-Korean summit held in April.
Как се стигна до тази наистина безпрецедентна среща, припомняме в следващия материал.
The Bulgarian National Television spent the most time on the subject, making short videos about the leader Kim Jong-un, and about the Korean War and how the events went to end at the US Democratic People's Republic of Korea summit. Here in Bulgaria, the news about the Korean Peninsula are not main focus, but still every media follows them with caution and hope for good results and peaceful life at East Asia.